Thank you very much, David. Yes, half the job done by England, but they need to get wickets again with this new ball. Saw the difference in the bounce in this pitch when the ball got a bit older. Kirsten still on naught. He's off the mark now.
First runs after lunch, or run, should I say, singular, not plural. And that also brings up the 100 for South Africa. Still trail, though, more importantly, by 110. England can whittle away.
It's a nice looking shot.
Well, it goes for four, and that brings Gary Kirsten a well-deserved 50. Hasn't been pretty at times, but a mighty important innings for the home team.
Yeah, really good gutsy fighting effort from Gary Kirsten. He's looked completely out of sorts, really, all series. But he's stuck in today and brought his 50 up with a really sweet piece of cricket. Classic stroke down the pitch. A bit of help from Chris Silverwood as well to get the four.
How frustrating is that for Silverwood and for Tufnell? A four go on his bowling analysis. No wicket for 33 so far. Well, I hope there was enough encouragement for Tufnell to continue over the wicket.
That's away. Through the gullies, four runs. Well, this is very much the style of Gary Kirsten. Doesn't mind the odd play and miss. If the next one is there to be hit or taken advantage of, he'll do it.
And when he's in good form, Gary Kirsten, this is the area he really loves to play his shots. Square, just behind square, off the front foot. And that confidence is now starting to come through.
Gary Kirsten into his stride here, really.
Back it.
Three more runs to him.
Good use of the feet, Gary Kirsten. Got right to the pitch of the ball. Found the gap. Good, solid play.
And that'll take a bit of polishing when it comes back from the boundary. You'll even find the ball going out of shape after a shot like that.
Nice straight drive. Silverwood might need that chase to get loosened up for a spell before tea. What about these overs, Ian, leading up to the next new ball? Who should be bowling?
Well, I'm not surprised Phil Tufnell isn't. I think he should be bowling. I think him and maybe a few from Flintoff, a few from Adams. I think the thing is to get them through quickly and cheaply.
It's away fine for four. That boundary will bring up the 150 for South Africa. Gary Kirsten into the 70s. He's 72. Jacques Callis has 47.
Well, it's down the leg side. Just a matter of helping it on its way.
Well bowled and well played. That is top-class cricket. Tufnell throwing up the tempter, giving it plenty of air, trying to get it to turn, and Kirsten quickly down the pitch, playing a lovely extra cover drive.
This terrific cricket, as Tufnell looks to get the ball into the rough, gives it air, puts plenty of spin on it. Saw things very, very quickly there, Kirsten. Down the pitch, nimble footwork.
That one's through the gap. Two extra cover. Hussain after this one. Will reach it just inside the fence. Knocks it back.
Catch it up.
Tufnell completes the work. It's 196 for two.
For Gary Kirsten, a bit of history for him. This is his 10th Test Match 100. He's the only South African ever to post 10 Test Match centuries, and it's a mighty valuable one for his team. He may have gone some of the way to saving this match for South Africa. A model of concentration and no mean skill in the second half of his innings.
And the Kingsmead crowd rise to Gary Kirsten, and rightly so. He really has had to concentrate hard. He's had to dig deep. He hasn't been in good form, but he's worked and worked very hard. He's now three figures. Really has been top innings by the left-handed opening batsman. First South African to score Test centuries in Test cricket, and what a time to do it.
Shout from Gough, changes his approach to come round the wicket to Kirsten. But big inside edge.
Kirsten fortunate to get the inside edge there. Just a little bit lax of concentration, one feels. Gary Kirsten, no footwork. Look at those feet. Just standing dead still.
A super shot. He can relax a little bit now. It's a glorious cricket stroke.
Dr. Ali Bakker approves. Certainly got his footwork right here. He leant into that one and smashed it through the vacant area between extra cover and mid-off. So South Africa now lead by one run.
And it's going to go all the way. Four more runs. Well, it just shows you how much rain there was here, as that pulled up very quickly in that bottom corner. Well chased by Mark Butcher.
Productive area for Gary Kirsten. One of those dart ball there, full and wide of off stump. Gets his arms free. Seen it like a football now, he's been in there so long. Kirsten's moved on to 112.
He's gone down and clubbed that over the top. I don't know what he's hitting, might just get there. Yeah, it does, it's wet. That side, it's round to the right from there, where it's still a little damp from the deluge before this game started. We also had a lot of rain last night, but he shouldn't mind that. That's out of the rough. That could have really gone anywhere.
looking for a maximum. Just does pitch in the rough, doesn't it? Takes something out of the surface. Looking to go over the top.
Despairing dive by Chris Silwood. Four more to Kirsten. Gary Kirsten onto 126.
Certainly doesn't lack concentration, Kirsten. He's not the prettiest player to watch.
I'm slightly surprised, Mike, that Andrew Caddick isn't into the attack first thing.
Away through the gap as well. That's going to go down to third man for four.
Yeah, and it's those sort of things, David, that you desperately need to go for you on a pitch like this, in a situation like this. Thick edge from Kirsten again. Didn't really have the pace to carry to where third slip would have been. Taggart.
Well, he's found the right part of the bat this time. Three more to Gary Kirsten.
Kirsten prepared to use his feet, and that single takes him to 150 now. Just 23 minutes short of 10 hours out in the Middle East, faced 405 balls. A monumental effort from Gary Kirsten.
Coming down the ground, keeping it off. Four more for Gary Kirsten. Boundary number 14, moves to 162, good shot. ...126, South Africa's lead, 336 for four. Hit away again. Now this is what England don't want to do. They've got to bowl maidens. Not to look to bowl maidens. Yeah, runs are very important here. Very important indeed. And back-to-back boundaries for Gary Kirsten. One through mid-off and one through cover. Another good shot. Boundary number 15.
The 148th over. Been out there for an eternity of England.
Good stroke from Kirsten. Bided his time, used his feet well, and has hit Tufnell away into the vacant onside for four.
Such a natural shot for a left-handed batsman, the left-arm spinner, bowling over the wicket, ball coming back into the body, just a free flow. Free flow of the bat and the arms, big vacant areas at deep mid-wicket. So natural a shot to play.
It's wide of cover point, won't go for four.
Well done, Cap.
Two more to Kirsten.
That's his area. Plays with an open face off the front foot.
That's a magnificent shot. Through extra cover this time from Kirsten. The bowling may be feeble, but you've still got to hit the ball to the boundary.
Yes. Placed it beautifully. Oh, Butcher giving chase. It's going to be a good contest, that one. And, well, did everything but claw it back. Good effort. Kirsten on to 189.
A little bit of bounce there for Darren Goff with this third new ball. Harry Kirsten just opening the face. Did time it well. Didn't look as though it was going to be a good contest, this. It was there. But
Kirsten gets in on the act as well against Silverwood. An expensive over for Chris Silverwood. That's 15 runs off it.
Chris Silverwood frustrated and forlorn. 15 from that over.
It's away fine. The race is on. Silverwood denies Kirsten this time. He's on 199. Boutch is on 99. 425 for four.
You don't want this, do you?
So it's Adams to Kirsten. Kirsten on 199.
For Gary Kirsten. A stay of 12 hours and 23 minutes now. He must be exhausted, but he'll remember this innings for the rest of his life. On the verge of being dropped for this test match, he scratched his way back to form. He first gave the innings some platform yesterday and now has gone on to take the match away from England and turn it into one for personal milestones from himself, Nasser Hussain and probably Mark Boucher as well.
No! Ah! Pulled away for four.
455 for five. Really sums it up. Well, you're sure he's trying to play it in the end, but he still gets four.
Applause for Gary Kirsten's highest score in Test match cricket.
Previous was also against England at Manchester, 210. That would be at least four. Third man had gone very, very square. Big, big gap there. I was thinking there might be one or two.
That's a bit straighter. Please, says Alex Stewart.
Please, says Alex Stewart. I think he's saying to Dave Carey, we've seen enough of this guy, yeah? He's been here a very long time. Give him out.
Please! Michael Atherton's not enjoying this chase, and he's not going to win it. That boundary takes Gary Kirsten past Eric Rowan into fourth place of all-time run scorers for South Africa. To 245 not out becomes Gary Kirsten's highest score in first class cricket. Record going after record. Cullinan's 275 not out now in his sights, just 31 runs away.
Sachi!
Yeah, I mean, the Kisarkans have shown a lot of, well, the Manu picture, enormous amount of character, because he would have been under enormous pressure. Well, that's his 250. It's come up in 851 minutes he's been at the crease. Make that 852 as it flips over. Mammoth effort from Gary Kirsten. I flew back with him from the Port Elizabeth game and he was a bit depressed there that things weren't going his way. Well, might be a different person flying back tonight to Cape Town. Them, it's just the way things have turned out. It's going to go through and it's going to go all the way to the boundary. Four more. Gary Kirsten.
Friendly stuff from Nasser Hussain. Yeah, I agree with you. It's an interesting concept, Ian, that you pick a tour squad now. It's England's bowling figures. Can't fault the bowlers, really. 36 overs, 1 for 70 for Andy Caddick, 30 overs from Chris Silverwood, 28 overs, 1 for 82, Gough, 30 overs, 2 for 67 from Andrew Flintoff as Kirsten helps himself to four more. Goes up to 262. 14 more for the record.
Well, I think we'll get a better chance.
Burns, come up.
High scorer for South Africa in an individual innings.
A bit wider, Spoons.
He goes level with Darryl Cullinan now, who made 275 not out for South Africa against New Zealand at Auckland at the end of February this year.
Well, he's still in 275.
Yes!
He's bowled him out, has he? Yes, he has. Unbelievable. So it's over for Gary Kirsten. 14 hours and 39 minutes. So Darryl Cullinan still shares the highest individual score with Gary Kirsten. The England players congratulate Gary Kirsten for this monumental effort for his country. Every single England player shaking hands with Kirsten. A quite marvellous effort from him. And I'm sure he'll get on the back from Darryl Cullinan as well. 275 for Gary Kirsten. He faced 643 balls in a stay of 14 hours and 39 minutes. And at the end of Kirsten's innings, the players troop off. This test match is drawn. It's been an interesting test match all but the last session when it was all about personal milestones for Gary Kirsten. But England will have to go to Cape Town, still one down in this series. They've played a lot better since the Wanderers at Johannesburg, creditably at Port Elizabeth. And they were in front in this match for most of the way. But Mark Butcher spoils one party anyway. Kirsten looking for that single and the ball just grazes his leg stump, removes the bail, and his fantastic innings comes to an end. And so too this test match. 572 for seven then, the South African second innings score. And that innings all about one man, Gary Kirsten, a century two for night watchman Mark Boucher. They took the game out of England's reach in mid-afternoon today, but Kirsten's stay at the crease, a quite phenomenal effort of concentration. But I think, David, England can go to Cape Town with some...